In physics, Planck units are physical units of measurement defined exclusively in terms of five universal physical constants listed below, in such a manner that these five physical constants take on the numerical value of one when expressed in terms of these units. Planck units have profound significance for theoretical physics since they elegantly simplify several recurring algebraic expressions of physical law. By non-dimensionalization, they are particularly relevant in research on unified theories such as quantum gravity. Overview. Originally proposed in 1899 by German physicist Max Planck. These units are also known as natural units because the origin of their definition comes only from properties of nature and not from any human construct. Planck units are only one system of several systems of natural units, but these units are not based on properties of any prototype object or particle, but rather on only the properties of free space. The universal constants that Planck units, by definition, normalize to 1 are the gravitational constant, g, the reduced Planck constant, h, the speed of light in a vacuum, c, the Coulomb constant, minus 1, and the Boltzmann constant, kb. Each of these constants can be associated with at least one fundamental physical theory. C with special relativity and electromagnetism, G with general relativity and Newtonian gravity, H with quantum mechanics, epsilon zero with electrostatics, and KB with statistical mechanics and thermodynamics. Planck units are free of anthropocentric arbitrariness. Some physicists argue that communication with extraterrestrial intelligence would have to employ such a system of units in order to be understood, unlike the meter and second, which exist as base units in the SI system for historical reasons. The Planck length and Planck time are conceptually linked at a fundamental physical level. Natural units help physicists to reframe questions. Frank Wilczek puts it succinctly. We see that the question posed is not, why is gravity so feeble, but rather, why is the proton's mass so small, for in natural units, the strength of gravity simply is what it is, a primary quantity, while the proton's mass is the tiny number, 1. While it is true that the electrostatic repulsive force between two protons greatly exceeds the gravitational attractive force between the same two protons, this is not about the relative strengths of the two fundamental forces. From the point of view of Planck units, this is comparing apples to oranges, because mass and electric charge are incommensurable quantities. Rather, the disparity of magnitude of force is a manifestation of the fact that the charge on the protons is approximately the unit charge, but the mass of the protons is far less than the unit mass. Base units. All systems of measurement feature base units. In the International System of Units, for example, the base unit of length is the meter. In the system of Planck units, the Planck base unit of length is known simply as the Planck length, the base unit of time is the Planck time, and so on. These units are derived from the five-dimensional universal physical constants of Table 1, in such a manner that these constants are eliminated from fundamental equations of physical law when physical quantities are expressed in terms of Planck units. For example, Newton's law of universal gravitation can be expressed as both equations are dimensionally consistent and equally valid in any system of units, but the second equation, with g missing, is relating only dimensionless quantities since any ratio of two like-dimensioned quantities is a dimensionless quantity. If by a shorthand convention, it is axiomatically understood that all physical quantities are expressed in terms of Planck units, the ratios above may be expressed simply with the symbols of physical quantity, without being scaled by their corresponding unit. In order for this last equation to be valid, f, m1, m2, and r are understood to be the dimensionless numerical values of these quantities measured in terms of Planck units. This is why Planck units or any other use of natural units should be employed with Kerr, referring to g equals c equals 1, Paul S. Wesson wrote that, mathematically it is an acceptable trick which saves labor. Physically it represents a loss of information and can lead to confusion. Key. L equals length, M equals mass, T equals time, Q equals electric charge, theta equals temperature. As can be seen above, the gravitational attractive force of two bodies of one Planck mass each, set apart by one Planck length, is one Planck force. Likewise, the distance traveled by light during one Planck time is one Planck length. To determine, in terms of SI or another existing system of units, the quantitative values of the five base Planck units, those two equations and three others must be satisfied to determine the five unknown quantities that define the base Planck units. Solving the five equations above for the five unknowns results in a unique set of values for the five base Planck units. Table 2. Base Planck units, derived units. In any system of measurement, units for many physical quantities can be derived from base units. Table 3 offers a sample of derived Planck units, some of which in fact are seldom used. As with the base units, their use is mostly confined to theoretical physics because most of them are too large or too small for empirical or practical use, and there are large uncertainties in their values. Simplification of physical equations. Physical quantities that have different dimensions cannot be equated even if they are numerically equal. In theoretical physics, however, this scruple can be set aside by a process called non-dimensionalization. Table 4 shows how the use of Planck units simplifies many fundamental equations of physics. Because this gives each of the five fundamental constants, and products of them, a simple numeric value of 1. In the SI form, the units should be accounted for. In the non-dimensionalized form, the units, which are now Planck units, need not be written if their use is understood. Other possible normalizations. As already stated above, Planck units are derived by normalizing the numerical values of certain fundamental constants to 1. These normalizations are neither the only ones possible nor necessarily the best. Moreover, the choice of what factors to normalize among the factors appearing in the fundamental equations of physics is not evident, and the values of the Planck units are sensitive to this choice. There are several possible alternative normalizations. Gravity. In 1899, Newton's law of universal gravitation was still seen as exact, rather than as a convenient approximation holding for small velocities and masses. Hence Planck normalized to 1 the gravitational constant G in Newton's law. In theories emerging after 1899, G nearly always appears in formulae multiplied by 4 pi or a small integer multiple thereof. Hence, a choice to be made when designing a system of natural units is which, if any, instances of 4 pi appearing in the equations of physics are to be eliminated via the normalization. Normalizing 4 pi g to 1, Gauss's law for gravity becomes phi g equals minus m. The Bekenstein-Hawking formula for the entropy of a black hole in terms of its mass mbh and the area of its event horizon abh simplifies to sbh equals pi abh equals 2. Where ABH and MBH are both measured in a slight modification of reduced Planck units, described below. The characteristic impedance Z0 of gravitational radiation in free space becomes equal to 1. No factors of 4 pi appear in the gravito-electromagnetic equations, which hold in weak gravitational fields or locally flat space-time. These equations have the same form as Maxwell's equations of electromagnetism, with mass density replacing charge density, and with 1 replacing epsilon 0, setting 8 pi g equals 1. This would eliminate 8 pi g from the Einstein field equations, Einstein-Hilbert action, Friedmann equations, and the Poisson equation for gravitation. Planck units modified so that 8 pi g equals 1 are known as reduced Planck units, because the Planck mass is divided by square root 8 pi. Also, the Bekenstein-Hawking formula for the entropy of a black hole simplifies to SBh equals 22 equals 2 pi ABh, setting 16 pi g equals 1. This would eliminate the constant C4 from the Einstein-Hilbert action. The form of the Einstein field equations with cosmological constant lambda becomes r mu nu minus lambda g mu nu equals 2. Electromagnetism Planck normalized to 1, the Coulomb force constant 1. This sets the Planck impedance Zp equal to Z0 quarters pi, where Z0 is the characteristic impedance of free space, normalizing the permittivity of free space epsilon 0 to 1. Sets the permeability of free space micro 0 equals 1, sets the unit impedance or unit resistance to the characteristic impedance of free space, Zp equals Z0, eliminates 4 pi from the non-dimensionalized form of Maxwell's equations, eliminates epsilon 0 from the non-dimensionalized form of Coulomb's law, but has 4 pi r2 remaining in the denominator. Temperature Planck normalized to 1, the Boltzmann constant Kb, normalizing half a kilobyte to 1, removes the factor of 1/2 in the non-dimensionalized equation for the thermal energy per particle per degree of freedom, introduces a factor of 2 into the non-dimensionalized form of Boltzmann's entropy formula, does not affect the value of any base or derived Planck unit other than the Planck temperature, which it doubles. The factor 4 pi is ubiquitous in theoretical physics because the surface area of a sphere is 4 pi r2. This, along with the concept of flux, is the basis for the inverse square law. For example, gravitational and electrostatic fields produced by point charges have spherical symmetry. The 4 pi r2 appearing in the denominator of Coulomb's law, for example, follows from the flux of an electrostatic field being distributed uniformly on the surface of a sphere. Likewise for Newton's law of universal gravitation. Hence a substantial body of physical theory discovered since Planck suggests normalizing to 1 not g but 4 n pi g, for 1 of n equals 1, 2, or 4. Doing so would introduce a factor of 1, into the non-dimensionalized form of the law of universal gravitation, consistent with the modern formulation of Coulomb's law in terms of the vacuum permittivity. In fact, alternative normalizations frequently preserve the factor of 1 in the non-dimensionalized form of Coulomb's law as well, so that the non-dimensionalized Maxwell's equations for electromagnetism and gravitomagnetism both take the same form as those for electromagnetism in SI, which does not have any factors of 4 pi. Uncertainties in measured values. Table 2 clearly defines Planck units in terms of the fundamental constants, yet relative to other units of measurement such as SI, the values of the Planck units are only known approximately. This is mostly due to uncertainty in the value of the gravitational constant g. Today the value of the speed of light c in SI units is not subject to measurement error, because the SI base unit of length, the meter, is now defined as the length of the path traveled by light in vacuum during a time interval of 1/299,792,458 of a second. Hence the value of C is now exact by definition, and contributes no uncertainty to the SI equivalence of the Planck units. The same is true of the value of the vacuum permittivity epsilon 0. Due to the definition of ampere, which sets the vacuum permeability mu 0 to 4 pi times 10⁻⁷ h per meter, and the fact that mu 0 epsilon 0 equals 1 c2, the numerical value of the reduced Planck constant has been determined experimentally to 44 parts per billion, while that of g has been determined experimentally to no better than 1 part in 8,300. G appears in the definition of almost every Planck unit in tables 2 and 3. Hence the uncertainty in the values of the table 2 and 3 SI equivalents of the Planck units derives almost entirely from uncertainty in the value of g.